to me, it's kind of like a youth group, and because I went to youth group and just growing up in the church, and so it's just been a nice way to just keep my faith with like-minded people and make more friends out of that.
Yeah, I think you're right that when people leave high school, especially if they were really involved in youth group, they're looking for that same kind of space where you can connect with your spirituality and you can be around friends and just be yourself. And campus ministry makes space for that. And I think that PECM in particular is really good at making space for people who don't have their beliefs figured out, who thought that they did maybe and they're refiguring it out, or they need a space to just think about big things in the world. It's really neat to be able to like know Caitlin from the time that we were freshmen until now, like about to graduate. And that doesn't happen in a lot of clubs and organizations in college.
So fun to have, to see what someone's like as a freshman, our first year, and then a senior, and then beyond. I always talk about one student who had never flown on a plane before. We went to New York on a trip, and now he's gone to graduate school in New York and did an internship with the Presbyterian Church, the United Nations. And I like to think that that trip sort of shifted him in that direction.
So on Tuesday evenings, we typically rotate through different programs like worship, TED Talks, or nights where we watch videos or maybe read things and talk about kind of either big pop culture issues or just things happening in the world. We also have a lot of game nights or trivia nights because it's important just to be able to be together in fellowship. And then we also do have several service opportunities. We also work with App Builds a Home, which is a side program of Habitat for Humanity. And so we've worked with them for a couple years now.
We also once a week meet for a Bible study, and so that typically is a smaller group, and read scripture and discuss it. And as college students, we're like figuring out what our views on the world are, and also like how have my parents raised me, and how has the church raised me, and how does that fit into my everyday life. And so being able to be in a safe space and discuss that with people and relate it to the Bible and relate it to our own lives is really cool and important. Coming to App State and then transitioning into college was not super easy or enjoyable. And I had a really hard time finding a community. And I realized that growing up, like all of my friends came from church and all of my friends came from like the Presbyterian Youth Council that I was on or the Presbyterian summer camp I attended. So I was like, wow, I really need to devote myself to campus ministry because that's where I've made all my friends in the past. And so there's probably a pretty good chance I'm going to make all my friends there here.
When I first came to App, there was someone from my church at home who I was in youth group with. She texted me and she was like, you have to go to PECM. Like, I've already given your phone number to Stephanie and she's going to text you and you're going to go get coffee and you're going to go to PECM. And I just remember the first night, like, I never felt like a stranger in that space. Like, it was just that people did such a great job of making you feel like that's where you were supposed to be.
So my freshman year, I had a New Testament class with Stephanie's husband, and also one of my friends from youth group back home. She was saying, oh, you definitely need to come. I was like, okay. And then I met with Dr. Hankins. He was, oh no, you definitely should come. And so I was like, I guess I definitely should come. Like the first night, I mean, I was kind of quiet because I just didn't know anyone at all, but I mean, it wasn't like I was sitting by myself. Like everyone talked to me. I mean, I've just made a lot of friends here. I've gotten a job out of it too at Rumpel and Blowing Rock. And it's just the community's been meant a lot to me.
I also think another thing that's important too, or has been important to me, is like the connection that PECM provides between you and like the rest of this whole big Presbyterian network, be it like adults that bring us meals or adults that are at churches that we go to. Having access to those people that don't even need to know you to love you, as long as you're a college student coming to campus ministries.
This past winter break, we got these like, they're not basket, yeah. The bags. I didn't think I knew anybody that gave me a letter, but they knew me, which really stuck out to
my
me.
My mom cried when she saw me open it.
Oh, really?
Like, this is the definition of love.
Because of COVID, we couldn't be together, so we got church members to write letters, and I mean, it was crazy how supportive the church was.
It was amazing. Yeah, it just didn't, like, I poured it out and it just didn't stop coming.
No, yeah.
It was incredible.
Yeah.
I think for so many young people, a lot of them tend to turn away from the church because of all the hate that we see coming from it. And PECM has never been a hateful space, and that's always been very clear to everyone that walks through. And so I think it's really helpful for young people to know that that does exist.
You know, often people talk about, oh, young people these days or whatever, but I'm so always optimistic about the future because I know all of you.
Like, there's always more that can be done, be it donating more food items or more just money, because that's what a lot of places need right now, especially in COVID, is for us to provide resources and them to know what those communities need and take care of that.
I have always wished that we had more resources to be able to not be worried about money too. Mm-hmm. I've done this for 8 years and I've been constantly worried about money, which is a good feeling because it makes me feel like I am always having to talk about this is a valuable thing, but I think it's the most valuable thing because I think if we lose people who are going to college, not that it's the purpose of campus ministry isn't to funnel people into church, but it's to keep people connected with their faith.
Like, my biggest defining moments growing up happened at Camp Hanover, which is a Presbyterian summer camp. And that's the reason why I'm a recreation management major. And so just continuing on with that support of the Presbyterian Church, like, I feel like it's investing in our development as humans and as functioning adults and as Christians and wanting the next generation to succeed and become the next generation of strong Presbyterians who will continue that support.
Yeah, and our Presbytery supports a good number of campus ministries, which I think says a lot about how important it is to them to support young people. And I love the connectionality of the Presbyterian Church. I love the people who bring us meals on Tuesday nights, and pre-COVID when we could sit down and have those meals and have those big questions that we would talk about with church members. I see how much the church members love connecting with you all on Sunday mornings or when they come bring a meal. It's so important to have the intergenerational connectivity, mm-hmm. and also the fact that there's churches, not just in our immediate area, but churches throughout the Presbytery and really in North Carolina at large that support campus ministries. I'm always grateful for the local churches that support us, for the Presbytery that supports us. And this is a ministry that's been in place for 75 years. A lot of college students have come and had a lot of meals and talked about God for a long time.